Hello, my brothers and sisters, all the black Hebrew Israelites. This is your fellow brother Michael, the servant of Yahuwah. I want to welcome you to my channel, and I want to give glory, honor, and praise to Most High Yahuwah. I want to thank him for the opportunity that he has given me to share the information with you. So I give you a little bit of my background. I was a Christian, spent many years in Christian doctrine. It's been about 2 years ago, Yahuwah has woke me up. And I want to make sure that, you have to subscribe to my channel. And I believe that you're going to be learning a lot of stuff, a lot of brand new information. And I'm very humble and grateful to serve the Most High. You know, in this channel, you're going to receive a lot of information. You know, we're all working toward the same kingdom. We are the servants of our Master Yahushua HaMashiach. So I want to welcome you. And today we're going to be talking about Christianity false doctrine. You know, this is Satan's greatest deception of the 21st century. You know, if you are Christian, you go to Sunday church, you know, I can just tell you that you have been deceived. You know, you have to run away from Sunday church before it's too late. You know, I really mean it. And I'm going to prove you how the devil used Christianity to deceive many. You know, all these folks, you know, to go to church on Sunday, you know, you see a lot of Hebrew Israelites. You know, most of them, they love to serve Yahuwah. But unfortunately, they got deceived. You know, they're serving the wrong God. His name even is not even God, you know. His name is Yahuwah, you know, the creator of the earth and the heavens. You know, he created all things in 6 days and created us by his own image and his own likeness. Let's go to the book of Genesis 2, 1 to 3. Let's read. That the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day, Yahuwah ended his work, which he has made. He rested on the seventh day from all the work which he has made. And Yahuwah blessed the seventh day and sanctified, because that it he had rest from all his work which Yahuwah created and made. You see, this is amazing, because in the scripture saying that Yahuwah blessed the seventh day, you know, Yahuwah did not bless the first day of the week, which is Sunday. He did not bless Monday. You know, like, this deception is so deeper, and a lot of Christian Sunday worship, you know, it's just leading people to delusion. He has created the earth and the heavens. He created the moon. He created the sun first and the moon. And the sun to rule over the day and the moon over the night. He created the stars. He created the animals. You know, he created us by his own image, in his own likeness, male and female. Let's go to the book of Exodus 28:11. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, but on the seventh day is the Sabbath of Yahuwah, thy Elohim. In it thou shalt not do any work, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, nor thy maidservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, thy stranger, thy reside within thy gates. For 6 days Yahuwah made the heavens and the earth, the sea and all that in them, and rested on the seventh day. Wherefore Yahuwah blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Yahuwah blessed the Sabbath day. As I say, Yahuwah did not bless Sunday. You know, a lot of people, a lot of Christians, they are deceived. Christianity will tell you that Sunday became the new Sabbath day. It is not written anywhere. You know, this is a deception. You know, they're gonna tell you that, oh, every day is Sunday, every day is Saturday. Oh, because there is a scripture that Yahushua said that men shall always pray without ceasing. That doesn't mean that you should not keep the Sabbath day. Sabbath day is like a mandatory, is a commandment. Let's read in the book of Leviticus 23:3, 6 days shall work be done, but at the seventh day is the day of Sabbath, of rest and holy convocation. You shall do no work therein. It is the Sabbath of Yahuwah in all your dwellings. Did you see that? All your dwellings. Holy convocation. It means that the church, the worship should be held on the Sabbath day. The Sabbath day, the day of the rest. The holy day of Yahuwah. You know, unfortunately, every Sundays, everywhere you go, you're going to see churches packed full with Christians, believers of Jesus Christ. You know, they believe in Jesus. His name is not even Jesus Christ. And the deception is so deep that you even have any clue. You know, all these Sunday preachers, they're pushing the deception. You know, they're dragging people to the deception because they know what they're doing. You know, this is a worldwide problem. You know, if you are black, evil Israel, this is the time to wake up. You know, to wake up to the truth. You know, the word said that the truth shall set you free. You know, everywhere you go on a Sunday, you see people go to worship the Father. But I'm telling you that they are deceived because they do not worship the Father. I'm going to show you today, I'm going to give you proof and evidence that Sunday worship is actually Baal worship. Sunday worship has nothing to do with Yahuwah. You know, those folks, they are deceived. I believe there are many of them also, they have hungry for the word. They are thirsty for the word, but they're receiving false doctrine. You know, look at this pulpit, for example. This is Joel and hosting Lakewood Church, man. Like, look at the pulpit. It look like a knight. This is Freemason, man. I just don't understand. People go to church and they see things like this. They can't move, man. They just believe. You know, this is deception right there. You know, everywhere on Sunday, worldwide, Christians go to church on Sunday. Or Catholic, Protestant, they all are deceived. You know, this preacher, they're serving the same master. They're serving the same enemy, you know, which is the devil. You know, that's amazing. Like, you see, they got the same agenda. They're working toward the new world order. So you got to wake up. You know, if you are Christian or you have a family member who is Christian, you know, you got to be praying for them because they are deceived. I'm telling you, they're making their way slowly to hell because nobody will enter the kingdom of Yahuwah if you do not keep the Sabbath day. I will show you that in the scripture today. You know, the Catholic Church has been a deception. You know, this is the leading deception. In the book of Revelation 14:8, they're talking about that. You know, he take the nation, drink the wine of the wrath of the fornication. Catholic Church is like a pyramid, is the leader of all these denominations. You know, they teach false teachings. The dead go straight to heaven. Man is immortal. Sunday law. You know, Sunday is the law day. The Ten Commandments are abolished. Salvation by works alone, baptism by sprinkling, a secret rapture. If you talk to a Christian, you say that the rapture is a deception, probably they're going to say something is wrong with this man. But they are just blind, you know. It's amazing because people can't understand, you know. The truth is came out. Yah is waking up his people. Yah is waking up his chosen one. Christianity, biggest deception and false doctrine. They tell you that Sunday is the Lord day, not Sabbath day. That's a false doctrine. It's a demonic doctrine. Ten commandments are abolished. The Ten Commandments apply only to fake Jews, like in the wilderness, those that we've seen in the Middle East, you know, those are fake Jews. The true Israelite Jews are black people, African Americans, you know. I used to be a Christian for many years, and one of the things that my pastor used to teach in a church, she said that God, you know, Yahuwah, gave the Ten Commandments only to Moses for the children of the Israelites. So the Ten Commandments is the things of the past, because we are in the new covenant and we've done with the law. What a deception. That's a lie, because the laws of Moses is still applying today, except the sacrifice. If you sacrifice a bull or an animal when you sin, and the time back in the days, you know, in the wilderness, Yah has commanded Moses, if someone sin, you're gonna have to sacrifice an animal for your sin to be forgiven, you know. Since Yahushua came, he is our first Passover, you know. He sacrificed his blood for all of us, so we don't need to sacrifice animal any longer. But that doesn't mean that we've done with the Lord, we get away with the Lord. That's a deception. Receive Jesus, Yahushua, from your lips, and you are automatically saved. That's another false doctrine. You're gonna see, and every Sunday, pastors, they ask the visitor, for example, if there's anyone who never received Christ in his life, you know, pastor would do a little prayer, maybe 3-4 minutes prayer, and people will clap their hands. They say, wow, born again Christian. They will sing with joy. But look, the same day, the same person who received Jesus in the morning in the church, in the congregation, you may find him in a bar, you know, or he's committing adultery or fornication, lying, bitterness, you know, envy, sexual immorality, you know, like the speech that the man, the gentleman, the lady made in the church in the morning, it completely vanished. That's a deception, you know. Receive Jesus from your lips, you are automatically saved. That's a lie. We are living in a time of grace, done with the law. False doctrine, lie. And this is a demonic teaching, you know. As I said, the laws are still applying up to now, you know. The laws are still valid up to now. Pastor is your spiritual leader, not Christ Yahushua any longer. That's a demonic teaching, you know. That's why the pastors, they control people's life. Serve your pastor faithfully by tapping to the anointing. You'll be blessed, you know. People serve men, they serve the pastor, they serve the pastor. The pastor became like their gods, you know. People serve the pastors with their families, you know, because they want to tap to the anointing, they want to be blessed. That's a false doctrine. That's a demonic doctrine. It's not even written in the Bible. If you don't give, you are robbing from God, you know, so you are cursed. Wow. That's another lie, you know. Like the previous church that I used to go for many years, my pastor would say that if you don't give your tithe, you will be cursed. She usually used the scripture from Malachi 3:10, where the scripture says, bring me your tithe and an offering. You know, try me on this. If I will not open the windows of heaven and pour out such a blessing, so you may not even have a place to contain them. Try me on this. But Yahuwah is talking about food. so may have food in his house, you know, like the devil twisted his word. You know, pastors today, they're talking about money. You know, you have pastor, you are rich, you are driving expensive cars, living in a big mansion, you have an airplane, but in your congregation, in your church, there are people who have no food in the fridge. You know, you call yourself pastor, the man of God. That's a lie, deception from the enemy. You know, you need the pastor to release you. If you decided to leave the church, that the spirit of control, it's unbiblical. You don't need your pastor permission, you know, to leave the church. When Yah touch you, when Yah open your eyes, when Yah wake you up, you gotta leave immediately. You don't need to tell your pastor, you know, you don't need your pastor permission or approval, you know. Church is an organization, money-making business system owned by the church founder and his family. You know, the pastor is the head, not Christ. You know, it means that when a pastor dies, we'll take over his wife or his son or his daughter, whatever. You know, the same thing going on. This is a business, you know. People use the church like a money-making system, you know. That's a business. They want people to continue to come, to continue to give. You know, more members you have, more people you have, more money you collect. Pastor's primary goal, focus in the church, physical growth, not spiritual growth. You know, he doesn't care even if you were in a bar yesterday, or you were drunk, or you have you committed sexual immorality, you know, fornication. As long as that you are in the church in the next morning and Sunday morning, you know, you are faithful member. You know, pastor is okay for that. You know, your physical presence is more important than your physical. You know, like my previous pastor used to say, "Oh, the gospel is free, but the church is not free." Like, unbelievable. Christmas is the day that Christ was born. That's a pagan feast, you know. It's a pagan feast. You're gonna see churches today, Christianity, they celebrate Christmas, they put Christmas tree. This is a pagan party, a pagan feast. Meanwhile, Yah has his party, his feast, on the book of Leviticus 23. Seven feasts that he has commanded us to keep, to celebrate this feast through the generations. You know, I've been in a church, I never heard about the feast of Yahuwah in the Bible. You know, no pastor talk about it. You know, like most of the pastors, they only focus on the book of the Acts of the Apostles. You know, they talk about Apostle Paul, like the New Testament, you know. That's a big deception. Christianity is the biggest deception ever. Like, a lot of people go to Sunday church, they are leading their way to hell. I will prove you, I will show you evidence why Sunday worship is actually Baal worship. The pastor is the shepherd of the congregation, not Christ Yahushua. So the pastor decide, you know, the pastor decide in everything, you know, every property that the church buy, it's usually on the name of the pastor and his family. You know, like, church is a business. That's why all these mega church pastors, they became rich, you know, because they build an organization, you know, like a money-making system to collect money from everywhere. They write books, you know, they sell books, they make millions, man, like, unbelievable. Not, let's go now. Here, I'm gonna show you what I was talking about the Sunday church. The Sunday church doctrine is the demonic doctrine. Let's read. Sunday was another work day in the Roman Empire on March 7, 321. However, Roman Emperor Constantine the Great issued a civil decree making Sunday a day of rest from labor. stating all judges and the city people and the craftsmen shall rest upon the venerable day of the sun. Oh my goodness, did you see that? The day of the sun. It means that this guy never been a Christian in any way, but he have changed Yah laws from Saturday to Sunday. You know, Constantine the Great was a sun god worshiper. When Christians go to Sunday, they say Saturday became the new Sunday. Actually, they're giving praise and glory to Baal, to sun god Baal. Wow. Emperor Constantine the Great was a pagan Christian. He never been a Christian from the first place. Born in 280, died in 337 AD, remained pagan, was never a Christian, and he was the first pope. Wow. Can you understand that? You know, a lot of Christians are brothers and sisters. You know, when me, I received Yah woke me up, me and my family, people were saying something wrong with me because I decided to leave Sunday church and to keep Saturday, to celebrate Sabbath day, you know, to keep Yah feast. You know, like they are accusing me. You know, if you are Hebrew Israelites, you're probably going to go through some tough time, you know, within your own family. You're going to see people who hate you, you know. But remember, you are not doing the work to please a man, but you are doing this work to please Yahuwah, you know. Sun God worship is happening worldwide. Look at the Statues of Liberty, you know, represent sun God worship, you know. It's amazing. Like, I don't understand why people cannot understand. It's very, very simple. Sunday church worship means worship day of the sun god. Wow. Christianity, Sunday believers are deceived. You know, are deceived, badly deceived. You know, look at the Pope Francis, man. Like, you know, they all worship Baal. Man, this is not the Yah that we worship. They worship their God, you know. They worship their God, which is Baal, it's Lucifer, you know. Like, some of them even sold their souls to the enemy, you know. America is the new Egypt. The same obelisk we've seen in Egypt, now it is in Washington, D.C. You know, people go to Washington, D.C., they are proud taking pictures before this obelisk, you know, symbol. It's a pagan symbol, man. You know, America is the new Egypt. You know, in the book of Ezra, you are talking about that it's going to take the children of Israel after the 400 years, you know, where they're going to live with great substance. I just want to give you a little bit of revelation, because Yah revealed to me the great substance that he's talking about in the book of Ezra is actually the work that we do, you know, right now, the work that you're doing for Yahuwah, to preach the truth to others, you know, to celebrate the Sabbath day, you know, to keep his feast and to teach others to do the same. You know, that's your great substance, because we're going to be reigning with Yahushua for 1,000 years. 1,000 years, we're in the new Jerusalem, the new earth, where we will be kings and queens, you know, prince and princess. So do the work of the master with love, because the reward is so big. Look at this idol, man. This is idol worship. You know, same thing happened in the past, in Canaan, in the wilderness. Same thing we have seen today in our Wall Streets. You know, there is no anything new under the sun. Sunday worship, worship day of the sun god. Or sun god day of worship, man. Like, if you never understood that meaning, Sunday. Sunday. The day of sun god. Let's read in the book of Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee. Thou shalt not be priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy Yahuwah. I will also forget thy children. You see, they did neglect the law. They did forget about the law, and Yah also reject them. Many Christians will say that we're living in a time of grace. We are done with the laws. We run away with the laws. You know, the laws are no longer valid. That's a lie. That's another lie. You know, these preachers, you know, mega church preachers, you know, all these guys, Kenneth Copeland, man, they all work for the same master. They have the same goals, because the Catholic Church is actually the daughters, the mother of all the churches, like Christian, Pentecostals, you know, all these branches church. They are the daughters of the Catholic Church. Let's go now to the book of Isaiah 56, 1 to 6. That say, Yahuwah, keep ye my judgment and do justice, for my salvation is near to come, and my righteousness to be revealed. Blessed is the man that keep this, and the son of man that lay hold on it, that keep the Sabbath from polluting it, and keep his hand from doing any evil. You see, even in the Sabbath, you cannot just act anyhow. You know, Sabbath day is the day of Yah. You need to meditate on his work. You need to spend time in a prayer, worship, praise, because it's a holy day. It's the day of the rest, you know. You don't need to pollute that day. Neither lay the son of stranger that had joined himself. Yahuwah speaks, saying, Yahuwah has done adultery, separated me from his people. Neither let the Enoch say, behold, I'm a dry tree. For that say that Yahuwah unto the Enoch that keep my Sabbath and choose the thing that please me and take hold on my covenant. Man, this is very serious business. You know, I'm just like a speechless, you know. You know, my heart is going to all these people, you know, all these Christians, man. I have a lot of family members as well. They go to church still on Sunday, even though I am trying to tell them the truth, man. Like for these particular people, the only thing that we have to do for them is just to pray to them, to believe here, to wake them up. 2 Chronicles 36:21, to fulfill the word of Yahuwah by the mouth of Jeremiah, until the land has enjoyed her Sabbath. For as long as they lay desolate, she kept Sabbath to fulfill 70 years. You see, there's a lot of benefits to keep the Sabbath. You know, when it comes to the blessing, man, when you keep the Sabbath, but you keep the commandment, you keep your statutes, man, you will be blessed. Everything will go well with you, because that's the scripture. Yah has commanded us to keep the Sabbath forever. It is a sign between him and men. It is a sign. I'm going to show you soon in the scripture. Many people get married on the Sabbath day, you know, they do all kind of activity on the Sabbath day, parties on the Sabbath day, birthday on the Sabbath day, you know, all kind of feasts on the Sabbath day, you know. Saturday is kind of a day that the enemy used in order to deceive the mass, to deceive people, man. Like, you know, graduation ceremony on the Sabbath day as well. You know, all these things, you know, it's going against the fourth commandment, which say, remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. You know, it's a commandment. Isaiah 58, 13 to 14, if thou turn away thy foot from the Sabbath, from doing any thy pleasure on my holy day, and call the Sabbath a delight, the holy of Yahuwah, honorable, and shall honor him, not doing thy own ways, nor finding thy own pleasure, nor speaking thy own words. Did you see that? Even the way to speak, you can't speak anyhow on the Sabbath day. You know, you have to keep yourself set apart. You have to keep yourself, you know, apart. You have to walk according to the scripture, not talking anyhow, not gossiping, you know, not insulting, offending or mocking people. We have to fear Yah, you know. Then it shall not delight thyself in Yahuwah, and I will cause thee to ride upon the high places of the earth, and feed thee with the heritage of Jacob thy father, for the mouth of Yahuwah has spoken it. Oh man, like this is so great, you know. This kind of scripture, you're never gonna hear them from Sunday church preachers, you know. They don't even talk about these things. I've been a Christian for many years. My pastor never spoke about Saturday. For the first time, Yah woke me up and my family. I discovered all these scriptures is in the Bible, the book of Ezekiel 20:20, and hallow my Sabbath, and thou shall be a sign between me and you, that ye may know that I am Yahuwah, that Elohim. It is what? It is a sign between man and Yah. Keeping a Sabbath is a sign. Let's go now to the book of Luke. This is the New Testament. We're gonna see what Yahusha was doing back on his time. Let's read. And Yahusha returning in the power of the Spirit of Galilee, and they went out to fame him through all the region around about, and taught in the synagogues, and be glorified of all. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and his custom was, he went into the synagogue when on Sabbath day, and stood up for to read the word on Sabbath day, not on Sunday. You know, you can check in the New Testament, you will never gonna find the scripture where it said that the apostle Paul, or even the disciples, went to the synagogue on Sunday. Sunday is a man-made day, but Saturday is Yah day. Sunday law is coming soon, and Sunday law, it is the mark of the beast, because the mark of the beast, you have to have the title, the territory, the name, and, you know, those three things are the seal of Yah. Either you keep the Sabbath day, you're gonna have receive the seal of Yah, or you keeping going to church on Sunday, which will become the mark of the beast, because Sunday law is actually the mark of the beast. The enemy is not that stupid. A lot of people, they think like the mark of the beast is gonna be something like an ID or microchip or RFID on the right hands and the forehead. Well, I know the enemies used to play people minds, so you have to be very careful to keep the Sabbath day. I'm gonna show you what Yahusha said in the Gospel of Thomas. Let's read on 27. Yahusha said, if you do not fast as regard to the word, you will find the kingdom, and if you do not observe the Sabbath as Sabbath, you will not see the Father. It means that you will never gonna make the kingdom if you do not keep the Sabbath, man. That's one of the reasons that they kept all these books, you know. They removed them from the Bible. They kept them because they want to keep the secret, the truth from you and I. What are the benefits of the Sabbath day? Let's read in the book of Revelation 3:9-10. Since you have kept my command to endure patiently, I will also keep you from the hour of trial that is going to come on you all world to test the inhabitants of the earth. People say that, oh, they're gonna be a rapture. Man, the rapture is another big deception. I'm telling you that Christians, everybody will go through the tribulation. People will be persecuted by the Antichrist, especially if you are black people, Israelites. You have to be ready for that. Let's read in the book of Daniel 7:25, and he shall speak great words. He who, the Antichrist, against the Most High, and he shall wear up the scent of the Most High, and think to change times and laws, and they shall be given unto his hand until a time and time and the dividing of the time, which is 3 years and a half. The saints shall be delivered on the hands of who? The Antichrist. So the rapture is another deception, because the saints will go through tribulation. This is one of the failure of the Christianity false doctrine, because no pastor will prepare you, you know, because you have to be prepared. Remember the scripture that Yahushua said, that pray for your flight not to be in a winter, because he knows what he was talking about. He's talking about the great tribulation. People will flee, will go to some other places. You have to pray before it happens. Revelation 2:10, do not fear what you are about to suffer. Look, the devil is about to throw some of you into prison to test you, and you will suffer tribulation for 10 days. Did you see that? Tribulation for 10 days. Be faithful even unto death, and I will give you what? The crown of life. It means that Christians, they will be persecuted. They will go through tribulation. This deception of the rapture of church is a madman, is a demonic, you know, a plan from the enemy, created by Darwin in 1830, I believe. You know, it's a man-made system to deceive you, you know, so you won't be ready, you won't be able to prepare yourself, you know, before the tribulation comes. Let's read in a 2 Peter 2:9. If all this is so, Yahuwah knows how to rescue the godly from the trials, and the holy and righteousness for punishment and the day of judgment. Let's now go to the book of John 14:23. Yahushua answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. It means that we will live inside of that person. If you decided to love and keep his commandment, that's the fact. The 1 Kings 2:3, and keep the charge of Yahuwah that Elohim to walk in his way, to keep his statutes and his commandments and his judgment and his testimonies, as is written in the law of Moses, that you may prosper in all that does, within whatsoever that turn thyself. It's very clear. The book of Joseph also saying the same thing. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate day and night. Thou shalt do, observe to do according to all that is written therein. For thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and thou shalt have good success. This is the secret of prosperity. Prosperity is not giving more, sowing more, you reap more. This is, you know, it's not a deception for Christianity preachers, you know, Sunday preacher. They teach you to give more. You make them rich, you know. That's why they became rich. They're buying expensive luxurious cars, you know, driving expensive cars. And meanwhile, in the church, there are people who can't even afford to pay their bills. Let's now see, like, these guys, man, they've been, like, worshiping in the Sunday church, you know, all these pastors. You know, some of the pastors, they even don't carry their own Bible, man. Like, they don't even open their own door from the car. They have someone do for them, like they became like a, you know, kings, you know. Someone, KJV, blesses the man that walk not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor sit stand in the ways of sinners, nor sit in the seat of scoffers, but he is delight in the law of Yahuwah, that in his law he does meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bring forth its fruit in its season. His leaf also shall not wither. Whatsoever it does shall prosper. This is the secret of prosperity. The secret of prosperity is not like some preacher, TV preacher, they're asking you to sow money. Oh, that's a lie. You're not sowing money, but you're giving them money to be rich. You know, they twist the word. My, these people, they will be count, you know, the Yahuwah will hold them accountable. Let's go now in the book of Matthew 10, 34, 41. Yahusha said, "Think not I am come to send peace on earth. I am come not to send peace, but a sword. For I am come to set a man a variance against his father, and a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against a mother-in-law. And a man's foes shall be the all his own household. He that love father and mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that love son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. He that take not his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. He that finish his life shall lose it, and he shall lose his life for my sake shall find it. He that receive you receive me. He that receive me receive him who sent me." Wow, that amazing. The Matthew, the book of Matthew 5, 17, 20. "Think not I come to destroy the law." Wow, many preachers, they say that Yahusha came to abolish the law, which is not true. Look, the scripture say, "Think not I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say unto you, till the heaven and the earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled. Whosoever therefore shall break one of the least commandments and shall teach men, so he shall be called a least in the kingdom of heaven. Whosoever shall do and teach men to do the same will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I say unto you that except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, you shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven. You see that these pastors who've been preaching people every Sunday that we are done with the law, you know, they were never gonna make the kingdom because they break the laws of Yah. They break the laws. They supposed to teach men to keep the law, not to break the laws. Run away from Sunday church. Christianity has 2.4 billion people worldwide. My goodness, imagine if none of them keep the Sabbath, if none of them celebrate the feast, if none of them keep Yah commandments. These 2.42 billion, they are making their way where? To hell. This is a very sad news. That's why we have to be persistent. We have to fight for our family members, our friends, you know, our brothers and sisters who are still in a Sunday church. They are deceived. Only Yah can set them free. Christianity, Catholic Church has 1.285 billion and Protestant 920 million. You know, that's pretty much like almost a million. And the Christianity with a collective between 800 and more than 900 worldwide, 40% of all Christian church, you know. So the Protestant dominations are the daughters of the Catholic Church. Even though you're part of the Pentecost, the Holiness Church, the Methodist, or the Anglican, or the Lutherans, or the Reformed Presbyterian Church of Scotland, Mennonites, Amish, Adventist, Seventh-day Adventist, Baptist, man, you are all part of the daughters of the Catholic Church. It's like in a pyramid. The Catholic Church is in the head, in the top, and all the churches, branches are below. You know, it's like a pyramid. Like all these preachers that you've seen right now, they all teach the same thing. They teach deception. They are teaching people to advance in the kingdom of darkness, not the kingdom of Yah. You know, like all these guys, you know, Most of them, they teach prosperity gospel. You know, they are gospel preachers of prosperity. They are rich. You know, you see them driving expensive car, driving, they have plane, they have mansion, man. They make a lot of money, but in account of you and now. So people have to wake up and leave the Christianity doctrine church immediately before it's too late. You know, like a guy like T.D. Jakes, $150 billion. That's a lot of money, man. That's a lot of money. Because if you go to Africa, to some of the parts in Africa, like in the Central Africa, you know, you travel there, you're going to be experiencing something that you haven't seen before. You see parents, they have children, you know, they have no food, you know, like 5, 6, 7 years old. They're spending all day without food. Meanwhile, this pastor, they own millions. They have millions into their banks. Or they say, oh, we give to charity. That a joke. That's a joke. You know, you have to understand the They are greedy, man. They are greedy because they only think about themselves. They only think about themselves. All of them, they work for the same master. They have the same goal, to deceive. To deceive many, man. Like, it's unbelievable. People had to wake up because the Christianity doctrine is a Luciferian doctrine. There is no difference between that, what I'm saying, and the fact. The fact is that those people who go to church on Sunday, they're giving their worship to God, to false God. You know, that's the fact. Let's read what the book of Matthew 6:24 is saying. No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, and as he will hold the one and despise the other. You cannot serve Yahuwah and mammon. You cannot serve Yahuwah and money. You cannot love Yahuwah and money. You cannot love Yahuwah and the riches of this world, because the scripture say that you shall love Yahuwah with the all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, and you shall love thy neighbor as thyself. You know, this is another pastor from South of Africa, man. Same thing, they all do the same business, you know. They're benefiting from the congregation, you know. They build a multi-million church, you know. They have thousands of members. They're giving tax on a weekly basis. They're collecting a lot of money. They don't pay tax. They're becoming rich. And they're feeding people with deception. Another pastor from Africa, his name is Uber. This guy doing the same thing, man. This guy came in Canada, in Ottawa. He was preaching and telling people the phone numbers, the contact phone numbers, man. That's not anointing. That is demonic power. I think that's black magic, because it has nothing to do with the gospel. You know, here with another prophet of Malawi, his name is Bushuri, man. Like, they're all doing the same thing. There's nothing under the sun. Look on the back, you see the cross. They're showing what they wear, expensive clothes, man. Matthew 7:15-20, beware of false prophets which come to you in a sheep's and clothing. In worldly they have ravening wolves. You shall know them how by their fruit. Do men gather grapes and thorns and figs of thistles? Even every good tree bring forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bring what? Evil fruit. We will know them how? By the fruit. So people need to wake up. Wake up as soon as possible. You know somebody go to Sunday church? Call that person. If you are black, Hebrew, Israelite, you have been deceived. You have to wake up, because Yah is waking up his people. This is the time. We don't need to follow these guys. These pastors, they are always on TV every Sunday. You know, those are the most lucrative ministry in the world. Healing, miracle ministry, prophetic, and gospel. You know, those are the three ministries that make them rich. This pastor from South Africa was cut, you know, trying to raise somebody who was dead, but in fact the person hasn't been dead. You know, he was trying to trick people. You know, those guys, man, they can use all kind of stuff just to gain fame. You know, to get fame. You know, it's so sad, man. Like, look, you know, the person supposed to be dead woke up and the cancer was cut in offense, you know, a lie, mislead the people, man. That's crazy. You know, Ben Hill here is doing a thing, you know, annoying, whatever, you know, this is a show, man, like an entertainment. More it does, that's more fame he became and more money collects, you know. This is just in a business, you know, it's an unusual business. People need to flee from this type of church, this type of Sunday doctrine, you know. That's amazing, you know. You see a lot of people go celebrate and singing gospel, man, they calling the name of Hayah mistakenly, man. They're not even using his name, you know. They're using somebody else's name, you know. His name is not God, you know. His name is not Jehovah. You see the deception even big. I never thought even the Bible, you know, in a Bible, Satan can make some changes in the Bible. It is a fact, man. Like the pastor, this is another pastor from Nigeria, Pastor Chris Oyakilo. You know, look, the hands, Masonic hand gesture, man. You can just see it's part of the same group, you know, the same group. They're working for the same master toward the same goal, which is the new world order. You know, another pastor from Nigeria, this is a Joshua, TV Joshua, man. Like, you look at the hand gesture. How can you say that you are the man of God and you are doing demonic symbols? You know, it doesn't make any sense. You know, they think like they're fooling people, but they're fooling themselves, you know. Same thing we can see with that Crawford Dollar here, you know, the same sign, you know. You can see this is Joel Osteen, a satanic symbol, like, you know, this is unbelievable, man. Like, people can see these things, but they still asleep, you know. You can see that people are blinded, you know. Christianity, Sunday church, it looks like witchcraft because they use the power to control people, you know. People cannot see what wrong with them. People are blinded, spiritually blindness. You know, Billy Graham was, in fact, the 35th degree Freemason, man. I was very disappointed when I learned about it. Like I said, that people have no fear of Yahuwah, even to death. You know, you still want to intend to deceive people, man, because the enemy has deceived many. Why would you follow Satan? Because Satan will spend his eternity in hell. He will be locked up for 1,000 years in the lake of fire. I just don't understand how can people make such a decision to follow Lucifer in hell. Do you know how hard is the lake of fire? If anybody already see that lake of fire, that lake of fire has been prepared only for Lucifer and his angels, not a human being. People have to fear ya. People need to run away for anything related to evil stuff. This is another man. His name is Robert Schuller. You know, he was the friend of Billy Graham, assisting to become a 33 degree Freemason. You know, the word of Yah say in the book of Mark 8:36, for what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his soul? You know, you can be wealthy, you can be a billionaire, you can own many mansions, many cars, many properties, many business, but when you die, you leave everything. What shall it profit a man if he shall gain all the world and lose his own soul? You know, you can be the most powerful person, you can be the most powerful leader, you can be the most handsome person, the most beautiful girl, but these things, we're not gonna take you to heaven. You can have everything you want on earth, but what shall it profit to you if you lose your soul? This is a question that you gotta ask yourself. You know, another pastors, you know, TV preacher, Prince, Joseph Prince, and David Jeremiah, man, still doing the same thing. They show themselves that they are the part of the same club. Another one, TD Jakes here with the satanic symbols, you know, same club, doing the same old things. Pat Robertson, Kenneth Copeland as well. Perry Stone, John Agee, man, they all part of the same group, the same family. They're working toward the same goal, worshiping the master. They're worshiping the God. The God is not your God. The God is somebody else. It's the devil. Our Father is Yahuwah. You see, this is the difference. They just use the scripture. They use the word to deceive people. They preach the word of Yahuwah. But in fact, they do not know him. They do not have relationship with him. Same thing with the Charles Stanley and Robert Morris. They're all part of the same movement. They're doing the same game. Look here, Prince Harry and Meghan. You know, they're happy and they know what they are into. You know, Shaq and the leaders and they've left. They're all doing the same Masonic signs. You know, Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton. You know, this is so sad, man. You see African-American, black Hebrews, man, they joining, following the devil, man, because the devil will lead them where to this destruction, will lead them where to hell. You know, the real name of our Messiah is Yahushua HaMashiach. Sorry, folks, his name is not Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is actually the name of the enemy. Somebody put this name, you know, how come the letter J has been created over 400-500 years ago? Only letter J, man, like Jesus Christ is not his name. His real name is Yahushua HaMashiach, you know. Like somebody told me that I've seen pastors do miracles in the name of Jesus. I say yes, but there are people who they look for Yah in the truth, man. They look for Yah from their hearts, but they have been deceived. But Yah, you know, answer the prayer anyway. But there are also people that use the name of Jesus to perform some miracles, some demonic signs and wonders, you know. Like they are all deceived, especially these Sunday preachers, man. They all use the same name of Jesus Christ while they're performing some demonic voodoo power in their prophets. The name of our Heavenly Father is Yahuwah, not Jehovah. Jehovah is not his name. His name is Yahuwah. Oh, he's our Father. You know, he's our loving Father. This is his name. The name of Jehovah was added in the Bible translations, I think, by the Catholic Church as well. You know, they all use the same ways to deceive people. You know, some people may think, oh, Jesus was white. No, Jesus never been white. Jesus is black, black Hebrew Israelite. Like the real, the true Hebrew Israelites from the Bible, they are black. And Israel is located in the Central Africa, not in the Middle East. Israel location, the true biblical Israel, is between Central and South Africa. You know, that's the location of the true biblical Israelites. You know, these images, you know, we've seen movies, they show the movie of Jesus Christ, you know, Yahushua HaMashiach. They portray him as a white man. He never been a white man. Even the word saying in the book of the Revelation 1-14, he had hair like a wool and feet like what, like grass, dark skin. You gotta know that those are the missing books in the Bible purposely removed to hide the truth. You know, you gotta see there are a lot of books missing from the Bible, you know, like the book of Enoch, Jubilee, Ezra, Susanna, Baruch, you know, all these lists, you can find them separately. You can buy them on Amazon as well, or you can listen to them. Some of them are already in YouTube. You need to do the research. You need to wake up, especially if you're a black Hebrew Israelite, black man, black female. This is the time Yah is waking up his people before his son comes back. You know, I encourage you to also buy the Holy Bible 1611 King James Version. You know, this kingdom comes with some missing books. You know, you're gonna find few books in this Bible. You know, the purpose that they hide these books because they don't want you to know the truth. You know, actually, there are some books that are even very interesting, like the book of Ezra, for example. I heard, like, listen this in audio. The book of Ezra basically talk about the present, the past, and the future. What's gonna happen in the end of the world? The coming back of the Messiah on earth, and also there's the apocalypse of Peter. In fact, Peter was taken in the spiritual realms by Yahushua to visit hell. He visited hell, like. You know, I used to see a lot of preachers watching like Daystar or Sid Roth. It's supernatural. You know, we've seen pastors, they always claim, oh, I've seen Jesus. My soul left my body. I went to heaven and met Jesus. That's a deception, because first, his name is not even Jesus. Remember, the word said that the devil can transform himself as an angel of light. If you read the book, the story of Adam and Eve, one of the book also removed them from the Bible, you're going to see that the devil deceived them again. You know, after the first deception, he transformed himself like an angel of light and was singing praise to Yah. That's devil, to deceive them. So everything is possible and nothing's new under the sun. You know, so those are the seven feasts that Yahuwah has commanded us to celebrate forever. You know, contrary to pagan holidays, feasts created by the Catholic Church, such as Christmas, Good Friday, Easter, Halloween, Saint Valentine, you know, those are pagan feasts. You know, please do not get deceived. Study your Bible, do the research, you know, and the Holy Spirit will lead you to find the truth. You know, the word said that the truth will set you free, because the enemy has deceived many. You know, if you want to find more about the feast of Yah in the Bible, you have to read in a book called Leviticus 23. The first feast it basically is the first month of the year. Look, they even changed the calendar. The first month of the year is supposed to be in spring. Now the Roman, they created their own Gregory calendar, putting the first month of the year as January and the last month as December. Yah never created like that. The first month of the year is always spring. Spring is the first month of the year. So we celebrate the Passover and spring, and after that we do the unleavened bread and spring as well, the first fruits, feast of weeks, and Pentecost and spring as well. And that after that comes the Feast of Trumpets in fall, the Day of Atonement in fall, and Tabernacles and in fall as well. Those are the seven feasts that Yah has commanded us to celebrate through all the generation. I want to thank you for your time. First of all, I want to give praise to Most High. This is my first YouTube video. As I say, subscribe yourself to my channel. I have a lot of information to share with you. So if you are Black, Igbo, Israelite, this is your channel. You know, you're going to receive a lot of revelations, because Yah has revealed to me a couple information very important to share with the Igbo Israelite. Remember that Yahoo is about to come back. Remember that tribulation is near hand, is coming. People will go through tribulation. Yahushua said that we shall pray that your fly may not be in a winter. This is the time that we shall focus in prayer and fasting. We have to leave our comfort zone and seeking Yah. How? In prayer and fasting. We have to pray for our family members, those who are lost, those who are sick, going to Sunday church, they worshiping the God of Baal, the enemy, devil. We need Yah to deliver them, because if we don't pray for them, those people, they will make their way to hell. I want to thank you. So make sure to subscribe yourself. You can even share my links, my video, to friends, family members. And I want to thank you very much for your time. and have a great day.